Hello guys, today I just want to explain about industrial safety helmet requirements. Okay, let's have a look into what standard says about the safety helmet. So before this, we will just have a look around this. So ventilation on whole. So because why I'm explaining this, because there are some technical things in the slide. So we don't want to come back again and to see what it is. So you will have a better idea at least if you know this. So ventilation on whole, you can see here top of the head, a helmet in the top of the helmet there are some ventilations, and the whole helmet, the dome type, it is called as a mass of the helmet. And inside the helmet, the chin strap. Okay, this is the headband where it is in the front side of the head. And inside of the this whole is there, no? Like chin strap, headband, these all those things we call as a shell. And behind where there is a tight adjustment, this call as a nape strip, adjustment strip. Okay, let's go to the next slide. Safety helmet. So nowadays, industrial safety helmet is being used in construction very widely as part of the safety measure. It's important to know what standard says about industrial helmet requirements. So there are 10 tests to be done for safety helmets. The first one is helmet size. So a rough measurement should be taken from above the eyebrow, around the head at the furthest point of the back of the head and around. There should be no gaps at the top, front, back, and side of the head. Although it should not be painfully tight, the helmet should be worn for a few minutes to gauge the fit. So there are several sizes in the helmet as per the standard: small, medium, large. So small is 500 to 540 mm, medium is 540 to 590 mm, and large is 590 to 640 mm. The construction of helmet. So how the helmet is made, what standard says about this, let's have a look into. Shell should be dome shaped. Ironic or metallic component should not be used. Brim diameter has to be 6 mm, peak 50 mm diameter of the hole for ventilation. Diameter of the hole for ventilation should not exceed 6 mm and maintained at a distance not less than 15 mm from adjacent hole. Second point is the headband should be more than 30 mm in width. Cradle should be secured at a minimum of 4 anchoring points. Strap should be fitted such a that minimum clearance should at least 30 mm. Maximum clearance more than 80 mm. Chin strap should have minimum width of 19 mm directly attached to the shell. Nape strip should have minimum depth of 115 mm. Using S hook, 10 kg load is applied on chin strap, but even though it should not break after 10 minutes. So let's go to the third point, what it says. Climate condition test. So the helmet condition test we have to do, this manufacturer has to do. Very hot climate, helmet should keep in the temperature of 50 degrees Celsius to 5 degrees Celsius, means up and down, for continuous 4 hours in an oven. And very cold climate, a temperature of minus 10 degree to minus 2 degrees Celsius for 4 hours in a refrigerator. Heavy rainfall, water flowing all over the surface at 1 liter continuously for 4 hours. So the fourth test is shock absorption test for the helmet. The rectangular block having a horizontal striking surface of